Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam baraka nabiyyana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam tasliman kathira thumma amma ba'd. So inshallah ta'ala we're going to be learning a dua every day after Salat al-Asr throughout the month of Ramadan. Hopefully inshallah ta'ala we'll learn how to read that, how to recite it very well, how to memorize and the meaning of the dua inshallah azza wa jal. From Riyad Us Saliheen, if I might ask the parents just to keep their kids quiet please, jazakumullah khair. From Riyad Us Saliheen, Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala, hadith number 1467. قال وعن أنس رضي الله عنه وارضاه قال كان أكثر دعاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار متفق عليه. In this hadith Imam Nawawi رحمه الله reports from Anas رضي الله عنه قال the supplication most often recited by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Like this is the one that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم repeated the most, which means it has its own value, it's of course significance. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam repeated that the most. He said, "Qal Allahumma atina fid dunya hasana, O Allah, give us in this world that which is good, wa fil akhirati hasana, and in the hereafter that which is good, wa qina adhab-annar, and save us from the punishment of the fire." Allahumma ameen. Now, what does that mean? There's another narration for the dua in which begins by saying Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana. Our Lord, give us that which is good in this dunya. So the ulama, they comment and they says, first of all, when they say Allahumma in the Arabic language, it's an expression of what? Calling. Like saying, Ya Allah, that's what it means. Ya Allah. You say Allahumma, which is similar to the Hebrew actually pronunciation of when you say God, say Elohim. So Allahumma is saying, Ya Allah, in the most you revere Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, and of course the plural pronoun to show significance and show, of course, His glory subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I say, Allahumma, Ya Allah. Like as if saying, Ya Allah, in your greatest glory. Atina fid dunya hasana. But if you say Rabbana, it also very perfect for this dua. Why? Because the word Rabbana, now you're soliciting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one of the most important qualities and traits for Him. To be, of course, worthy of giving us, blessing we're asking for. And what is that? Him being the Lord. Being the Lord means He's the master. And in the common culture of human beings, master versus slave, Lord versus servant. And who is taking care of the slave and the servant? The Lord Himself. He's the one who's maintaining your livelihood, taking care of things for you, giving you shelter, giving you food, giving you everything. So it's very deserving that we, of course, when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Him by this beautiful attribute, being our Lord, Rabbana, our Lord, Rabbana. Because, Ya Allah, I know all what I'm asking for comes from You. So my Lord, provide this for me. Rabbana, atina fid dunya hasana. Ya Allah, O our Lord, give us in this world, give us that which is good. That which is good in this world. Now, when we say in this dunya, that which is good, first of all, is it even permissible to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for earthly things and worldly things? Is it permissible, Jama? Can you ask Allah for a nice car? Yes. Nice car. But you already have one, Jama. Right? You are allowed to ask Allah for a nice car. Are you allowed to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for success in your interview that's coming up? Of course. Is it okay to ask Allah for more money? Can you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you to get married? Can you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever matters of the dunya? There is absolutely nothing wrong of asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the matters of the dunya. And when we ask Allah for matters of the dunya, He says, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana. Give us that which is good in this dunya. So I'm not asking anything in particular, but I'm delegating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me that which is good in this dunya. Why? Because who knows what is best for you? The one who made you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you ask Allah, my Lord, give me that which is good for me in this dunya, whatever that is, that you get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I guarantee you it's good for you. So we say, Allahumma atina fid dunya hasana. Ya Allah, give us that which is good in this dunya. Now some people, they're so miserable that they only ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for matters of dunya. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قال وَمِنَ النَّاسِ فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُوا رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. Some people, they only ask Allah for matters of dunya. As for the akhirah, they don't care about. And then Allah says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُوا رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً. And then He says, and some others, they say, Ya Allah, give us good in this world and the hereafter. So the dua is the manifestation of this ayah. So the Prophet ﷺ, he used to say, O Allah, give us that which is good in this dunya, in this world, wa fil-akhirati hasana, and that which is good in the hereafter. That which is good in the hereafter. طيب, the hereafter, jama'ah. Isn't everything good in the hereafter? What do you guys think? In the hereafter, isn't everything good there? Huh? Not if it was in Jannah, right? Absolutely. So not everything is good, because if Allah qaddar Allah, someone ends up in Jahannam, in the hellfire, Allah al-musta'an. But if you go into al-Jannah, there is no doubt everything there in Jannah is what? It's good. So when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, give me that which is good in the hereafter, you're saying what? Al-Jannah, and what is so good in al-Jannah? But hold on a second, I just said that everything in Jannah is good, right? Yeah, but how good? Of course, the Jannah levels. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ar-Rahman, وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ, for the one who fears his Lord has two Jannahs, two gardens. And then after that he said what? وَمِنْ دُونِهِمَا جَنَّتَانِ, and there are two lesser Jannahs as well too. They're still good gardens, but not as excellent as the ones on the top. Why is that? Because Allah made it very clear. هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ. You do excellent, we give you excellence. You do good, we give you good. So, fair, right? So if you want to get the highest level of reward, right, level of hasana, then you need to offer that highest reward, how highest actually good deeds. So here when you ask Allah, رَبَّنَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا, Ya Allah, give us that which is the best in Jannah, in the Akhirah. Now, what is the level of reward in Jannah? The ulama, they say there are three major levels of reward in Jannah. Number one, the carnal delights, the physical delights. You eat, you drink, you enjoy physical pleasure. That's the first thing. Just similar to what we call today Maslow's, you know, hierarchy of needs. So the first thing is the physical needs being fulfilled, alhamdulillah, ba'amin. And what does Allah say about this? He says, khalidina fiha abada. This is going to be eternity. Like this food, drink, pleasure is forever. But is that sufficient for a human being? I mean, it could be by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what else do we look for? What else do we look for as human beings besides eating and drinking and food and so on? Comfort. We're looking for comfort, that emotional fulfillment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantees that for us. In the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yattali'u ala ahli al-jannah. He comes to the people of al-jannah. And he asks him, Ya ahli al-jannah, O people of Jannah, hal raditum? Are you pleased? Are you satisfied? You're pleased? They would say, absolutely. We are pleased, Ya Rabbi. He goes, shall I give you more? And for them, it's like, more than this? What else that we can get that is better and more than this? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رِضَايَ فَلَا أَسْخَطُ عَلَيْكُمْ بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا. I will grant you my rida, which means I will be pleased with you for eternity. And you will never be exposed to my wrath. I will never be displeased with you. Allahu Akbar. Imagine if you can have this rida from a human being. Someone you're always pursuing their pleasure. You always ask for them to look at you and just smile in your face. Imagine from a human being. How satisfactory that is when you get that from a human being. Whether it's a spouse, a child, or a parent, or anybody like that. How satisfactory that is. And here we're talking about who is jama'ah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he's pleased with you, what else do you need more than that? So that gives the people what? That great emotional satisfaction. Then comes the highest reward in al-Jannah, the greatest hasana in al-Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named that hasana in Jannah. He called it ziyada. What is that ziyada? He promised subhanahu wa ta'ala the people of al-Jannah, and that's the highest reward in al-Jannah. Do you guys know what is the highest reward in al-Jannah? It's the answer to this ultimate question that we all worry about in this dunya. And what is that question we all need an answer for? Where's God? Does he exist? Is there God? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the answer in a way that is the most pleasing. You will have the opportunity and the chance to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your own eyes in a manner that suits his majesty. That you will be able to see Allah azza wa jalla. And once you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all that sense of anxiety and worries and suspicion and uncertainty about God and so on, it's all gone. The ultimate reward in Al-Jannah is to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah make us among those who witness that event, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Now finally, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says here, وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ, and protect us against the punishment of the fire, of the hellfire. Now, a few things over here. Number one, in this dua, as you can see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked for one good thing, but he also asked what? Two things basically, from this dunya, and two things from the akhirah. What does that exactly mean? It's okay to ask from the dunya, but make sure that the akhirah is more important to you. As Allah says in the Quran subhanahu wa ta'ala, قال, the story of Qarun, when he says, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Whatever Allah subhanahu has blessed you with, seek the pleasure of the akhirah. The Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the pleasure for the akhirah. And don't forget about your share in dunya. Do not forget about your share in this world. Today, our life is the opposite. We see that we live everything for this world, and whatever spare time we have, we give it to the akhirah. Kind of messed up a little bit, Jama'ah. So that's why we need to recalibrate and make sure that when we ask more for the akhirah, and still, alhamdulillah, we'll never forget about our share from this dunya. وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ, you ask Allah to protect you from the fire of hell. Why? Because getting that good in this dunya and the akhirah, it will be dependent on you being on the path that will protect you from Jahannam. So this is more like saying, Ya Allah, show me the way in this dunya to do the thing that will protect me from falling into Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us that way, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us that which is good in this dunya and in the akhirah, and protect us from the fire of hell, Ya Allah. So let's repeat this dua together, inshallah, three times, bidni Allah azza wa jal. Allahumma, atina, fid-dunya hasana, wa fil-akhirati hasana, wa qina, adhab-annar. Allahumma, atina, fid-dunya hasana, wa fil-akhirati hasana, wa qina, عذاب النار. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم آمين. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. For those who would like to join us, inshallah, right now, we're going to...